Today, we'll be painting Mr. Fink, a beautiful creature often found in room D403. We're going to start today with some beautiful phthalo blue. Now you're just going to take this with your 2-inch brush, and dab it in there, get it real nice and brisk. And you're just going to start moving it all over. Just move it all across the board. Yeah.
Now you gotta understand, this is your own number.
Add anything you want. You want to add a little happy tree into the corner? You do that. This is your world. Such a beautiful painting. I just love painting. Brings out the serenity, I believe. You don't have to fill everything in completely. You can leave some white space, give it more of a grainy texture. You just gotta understand. You just have to make love. Now that we're done with the background, we're going to switch to a nice peachy color for his skin. We're just going to dip our little 2-inch brush in some odorless paint thinner, and then we're just going to beat the devil out of it. All right. Now that's done, we're going to dip our brush into the nice peachy color we mixed up ahead of time. I'm going to try to get it in as much of a parabolic shape as possible. Mr. Fink has a very parabolic head. Follow the contour of the parabola that is Mr. Fink's head. And you're going to use two different parabolas in order to complete the circle. Each color, I'm just going to finish with the inside of his head. Very full face. Very, very pink. Very peachy. You can make your Mr. Fink however you want. You can make him blushing. You can make him deep crimson red. There. It's a nice full face. Wow. Now that two parabolas have met and been filled in order to create the face, we're going to take two conic cuts that are going to act as the ears. Want to be just like a parabola, but slightly curved. There. The ears kind of go into the blue. That's all right. No such thing as mistakes. Only happy accidents. Now, we're going to switch out to a word from our sponsors.
And now a word from our sponsors, the Pi Day Company.
Hey there! You know, pizza is a triangle, right? You know what pizza used to be before it was a triangle? A circle. You know, circles remind me of pi. Speaking of pi, 3.14159265358979932238.
Hello. Welcome back to Painting with Ryan Ross. Now look, we're going to continue with our masterpiece, Mr. David Finkbeiner. I'm going to start by drawing the eyes. I just want to get a little deep black. You know. trigonometric equation. X squared plus y squared equals r squared. It's the equation of the circle. It'll guide you. Look at that. He just stares at your soul now, doesn't he? Now that we're done with that, we're going to work on facial hair. I'm just going to grab a little bit of our brown. We're just going to small, kind of like you're drawing little trees. You want to draw more than one, because...
Next, we'll be adding the teeth to our David Fink powder. What a beautiful creature, by the way. Okay, add some this nice... This nice better white. And his teeth, this middle, this one, half circles. It's kind of little lines for teeth. It's pretty perfect. Nobody's perfect. Martin's gonna keep painting. Best way to get success is to strive for success. After the teeth, after you finish your teeth and you do the Fink binder, you want to switch to the black, a nice deep black, to paint the nose with David Fink binder. The nose is going to be a little tricky sometimes, so it's just a little nose. Could be a big nose if you want to. Thank you for joining us to paint this beautiful David Fink binder. Beautiful, just like all you wonderful viewers at home.